Hey guys, we got Leveled here, and today we're going to be taking a look at Soundtrack by Twitch, the beta. If you're one of the lucky people who received an email telling you that you have granted access to the beta, this video is for you, especially if you haven't played around with it yet. There is what I consider to be a kind of confusing list of instructions, but we'll go through them one by one. The first thing that I realized is that now in the fill out form to get access to the beta, I filled out that I use Streamlabs OBS to stream, which is the truth. But I use OBS Studio only to record. That being said, you need to download and install a new version or a preview version as they call it for Streamlabs OBS. And I'm not gonna do that right now. If you would like to see a video on how to get Soundtrack to work on Streamlabs OBS, let me know in the comment section below. But today we're gonna be figuring out how to make it work in OBS Studio. If you are completely oblivious to what Soundtrack is, it's that little app basically that gives you music, there's playlists, and it allows you to play music that will not be figured in your VODs. That means that you cannot get DMCA takedowns if there's no music in your VODs, but while you're live streaming, people can hear the music. So when you click download, you download it. It's gonna ask you to log in with your Twitch account, and the installation is super fast. It will open up this screen right here where you can see a bunch of pre-made playlists, including playlists made by well-known streamers, which is interesting. And then here there's station based off categories, and at the bottom there's recently played. I haven't been playing around with it for too long. The fact is I already recorded the video once, but there were some issues and I had to start over again. All right, let's open up OBS Studio. When you actually install this app, that means that if you see this here, that means that you actually have a brand new plugin, a brand new source in your OBS Studio. If when installing the Soundtrack app, you had OBS Studio open, I absolutely advise you to turn it off and then turn it back on. So close OBS Studio, open OBS Studio back on, and when you click plus, you should have this thing called VOD audio for Soundtrack by Twitch. So you add it to whatever scene you want to be playing music on. I think that's kind of an annoying feature because you have to add it to every scene if you intend to be playing music on every single scene. But okay, at least that's what I think. But then you go to edit and advanced audio properties. If you have your screen and it's kind of like that, you just need to drag it up right there. And basically what happens is that this specific track source, which is also showing in your audio mixer, will be added to the sixth track. That means all of that will not be checked except for number six. If it's not the case, you need to check number six and nothing else for VOD audio for Soundtrack by Twitch, okay? And then desktop audio, you can leave everything checked but number six. So what I understand is happening is that it's rerouting everything to the VOD audio instead of desktop audio. But when you play music from the Twitch app, it will be playing on this source, desktop audio, which is kind of confusing now because it's still called desktop audio. So once you're sure, and then every other track can have all the tracks selected if you want to. Now, once you have that done, you are actually still not done. In my case, they tell you that if you play a song from the app, it will show up on desktop audio only and not be picked up by VOD, which is gonna be your VOD. That's a good sign. But then if you play a track from another source, like your game or, I don't know, Windows Media Player, it should be picked up by both, which is good. That means that your game sound and your alerts will be on your VOD. When I tried this the first time, it did not work. And that is because I had to reboot my computer. So if you made it all the way here, you need to reboot your computer. And then once you start OBS back on, you'll realize that you can play music like here. I'm only gonna play a little bit of it because I don't know how it's gonna work with OBS and YouTube. I don't know if those songs are YouTube cleared, but actually put that to the side. And then keep an eye on my audio mixer here. So when I play music from this, it will appear in audio and desktop audio. Okay, and when I play another source, for example, Media Player, that is my own song that I made for my music channel. Yes, I have a music channel. It should be playing in both this and also desktop audio, right? And there you go. Anyways, those are the basics of how to get this to work on your computer in OBS Studio. There will be a link in the description on, you know, the presentation of the whole Soundtrack beta and stuff like that. I will link that in the description, but also there's the audio configuration where it will tell you everything you need to know about the installation, everything that I showed in this video. Basically, I just read this documentation and then I knew how to do it, especially after restarting my computer. So those links will be in the description. Check them out, read them all, especially the frequently asked questions and stuff like that. I don't work for Twitch. I have no affiliation with Twitch. So most likely this will answer your question way better than I can. And once again, let me know if you want to see the Streamlabs OBS version of this. Now, one more thing that is very, very important for you to know is that if you go to gumroad.com/gallevel, you can find a bunch of overlay packs for to make your live streams look amazing. And they are, most of them are free, completely free actually. And the rest is super, super affordable. I'm talking cheaper than water. Look at that. Animated Halloween pack. It's cheaper than a bottle of water. It's 99 cents. And I even added some social media pop-ups that are free that you can get like the templates of. Another one here. This is the core animated overlay for only $5. Another Halloween overlay pack, but this one is completely free. Oh my God. Go check it out. Gumroad.com/gallevel and then follow me on social media. Another thing is that if you have any more questions about live streaming and stuff like that, you should definitely join my Discord. Link will also be in the description. And you can ask there. There's like 1,000+ streamers in there and we try to help each other in that sense. If you check out top right on your screen right now, you will most likely see what YouTube deems the best video to view right after this one. And at the bottom of that, you will see my most recent video. So go check him out right now. What are you waiting for? That being said, thank you guys so, so much for watching. I wish you guys next time. Go out there. Make me proud. Get a level. Out.